Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Azmanov. I blog all about food and cake. So if you like eating good food, decorating cakes, desserts, then this channel is for you. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you'd like to see more videos from me. Of course, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up as well. Today I'm making a cake with ruffles, fondant ruffles. Well, those of you who have made fondant ruffles before will know that it takes forever. Well, it's a long process. You gotta roll the paste, you gotta cut strips, ruffle each strip, then put them one by one. And I remember doing that process on a wedding cake, which was a three-tier wedding cake, and I was just beginning my cake decorating career, and I didn't calculate that into my pricing, so I ended up doing 6 hours on ruffles, and it was very frustrating because it took me forever. Anyway, since then I've learned my lesson, and if I don't take ruffles, fondant ruffles, and if I do, then I charge more. So that's what happened recently. I had a bar mitzvah cake, and the girl wanted ruffles, but it was not in her budget, so we decided to go with something else. So as luck would have it, Marvelous Mold sent me three beautiful molds. Romantic ruffles, lavish loops, and perfect petal pattern. I've used two on this cake, and I'll show you how. But the best part for me about ruffles, romantic ruffles, the mold, is that I don't have to sit and make individual ruffles. So for someone like me, it's perfect. Well, I don't have patience, so that is a big plus for me. So I called the customer and asked her, "Do you still want those ruffles?" So she said, "Yeah, but it's in out of my budget." So I said, "Well, now it is in your budget, so I'm going to make it." And the cake was originally a bar mitzvah cake with just a number 12 on top. And I wanted to make a video for you with a tutorial. So I said, how can I make it a little different? So I decided to swing the theme of Valentine's Day because it's coming soon. And I made the standing heart cake topper. So I'm hoping that you can use that in some, maybe a wedding cake or something like that. So first, let's make the cake topper. This one needs to get dried a bit. So I've got lavish loops, but there are a couple of other molds that might work just as well, and I'll put the links for you below as well. Now, I've dusted this liberally with cornstarch and then shaken off all the excess. I've got red satinized fondant, but any fondant that works for you will do. And I'm going to roll the fondant just about the same size as my mold, okay? And I'm going to put it on the onlay and press. And notice I started from the middle. This is just to avoid any air pockets inside so that I don't have any gaps in my... Now, I'm pressing it right inside the mold so that I get a good impression. I'm going to take my rolling pin and run across the corners so that all the excess will just cut away. You see that? Okay? Now, once I've got all the excess cut away, I'm going to peel that off and make sure I neaten the edges first. So you want to make sure that your edges are all nice and neat. Now that looks about okay. Now it's time to add this to the cake. Now you can apply this directly like an onlay to the cake if you want. In this case, I'm making a cake topper, so I'm going to remove this out. And the best way to do that is to actually just flip the mold and peel the mold away. So remember, fondant will stretch, but the mold will not. So if you pull the fondant away, you will end up ruining your designs. The best way is to pull the silicone away, let the silicone do the job of stretching. I'm going to use a pastry brush to remove all the excess flour. Now I'm using a heart-shaped foam to make my cake topper. So I'm going to place the onlay right on top, okay, right in the center so that my seams are at the top and the bottom. I'm going to make some more and line the pattern up and do the best I can to remove the excess from the sides as much as I can. I'm going to keep the seams for me on the sides all around the heart so that way I have a seam on the sides, not at the back. So I'm going to continue making more of these and adding them where necessary. I'm going to do the whole of the front and let it dry first for a couple of hours. This will make sure that it's easy for me to handle and I don't squash my fondant. Now for the romantic ruffles, I'm going to do exactly the same. I'm just going to use the ruffle mold and I've dusted it with cornstarch. As you can see, I've already started using it. Okay, I've used it once before. And I'm going to roll my fondant. Again, I'm going to keep it thick so that I have a good impression. I'm going to roll it and place it on the mold and make sure my mold goes inside all the grooves that are there inside so that I have a nice ruffle. Okay, making sure it's all inside. Now, because you've dusted, it's not going to get stuck. If you don't dust it, it's probably going to get stuck. So be careful and make sure you dust it well. Sometimes even vegetable shortening works, but for me, cornstarch works the best. So I'm going to make sure I get all the excess out. Okay. You can attach this to the cake directly, holding this against the cake and just peeling away the mold. But I'm going to do it like I normally do. You know, my preferred method is to pull away the fondant away from the mold and putting it in the fridge for a while. Now I'm going to dust the excess cornstarch, okay, and place this on a tray and put it in the fridge. Okay, I'm going to do one more so that I have a couple of onlays with me. I've got one more here. See, I'm just going to peel it away. And there you go. Now I'm going to put this in a tray and put it in the fridge. You see how these line up? I actually do line them up in the fridge so that way they kind of set up like that. And they're going to become a little firm before I put them on the cake. And you can see I have my cake already. Okay. Now you're going to be very gentle when you're putting it on the cake. But just put some water on the cake and that's it. I'm going to attach this one. Now the one on this, above this, is going to be much less because I need to have a kind of a pattern on the dress shape. So I'm going to cut my panel in two and I'm going to attach this on the cake. You see how that is? Okay, I'm going to put another one there. There you go. And I'm going to very gently, making sure not to dig inside the cake, okay, just cut away. Now use something that you can use as a guide, okay, so that you can gently cut away, making sure not to cut too much. There you go. Now I'm just following the pattern of the dress that I designed for my cake, but you can have something else in mind. And I have added the second tier on top. I will do the seams later, but I am going to first put my ruffles there. Okay, making sure that I have just enough so I can cut. As you see, I didn't put the whole ruffle because I do not want to have too much of my cake to remove and peel away. So you got to make sure that you do not put the whole panel there and then have it stuck to the cake. So those are my ruffles all done. You see how fast that was? Now the ruffles need a little bit of an edge to make them neat. So I'm going to use this classic pearl border mold. This is also from Marvelous Molds and I'll put the link for you below. If you go to my blog, you will have the whole tutorial in writing on what to do. So if you need more details, then you can go there first. I'll put the link for my blog below. And as you can see, I'm just pulling away the fondant, the mold, and dusting away excess. I'm just using some water to attach them to the on both sides of the ruffles, and later I'm going to use edible gold luster dust with vodka to just paint the edges. So that's kind of going to highlight the ruffles a little bit more. Then the top, I need to put a brooch. I'm using, again, this is the glimmer mold, brooch mold from Marvelous Molds again, and that's it. I'm just going to paint it a little bit of gold and I'm going to attach it to the top of the ruffles. Okay, so that's it. Now this is again the Flexabet molds collection, and I did a couple of fondant plaques and name tags for you last time, and there's a long video on how to do that, so you can refer to that if you need help with these letters, okay? But that's all I did. I just got some the word love and put that on the heart. Well, that was my Valentine theme fondant ruffle cake. I hope you find it useful. The standing heart topper can actually also be made very beautifully into a wedding cake a topper if you have it in white or any other color theme that you want. If you have any questions, feel free to ask at the bottom of this video. I will have all the links at the bottom of this video and the link to my blog. My blog usually has all the details, including the recipes for the cakes, for the fondant, frosting, buttercreams. I have over 30 buttercream recipes on my blog if you want, and 6 different fondant recipes. But most importantly, I have the whole tutorial in detail, including the timeline for how to decorate the cake. So make sure you get all the details on my blog. Well, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you find this tutorial useful. If you do like the tutorial, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.